part two of our ASI graphic design idea. This one, we're going to be adding it on a mock-up on a t-shirt, as well as quickly changing it to a 3D logo. Let's jump right in. Press T for text, and we're going to be using a font called Play. And you're going to type ASI in capital letters. Increase the text and make it 300, and let's rotate it 90 degrees. We're going to continue with our beautiful orange color. Then you're going to duplicate the text and align it next to the first text. Use your effects and create a hollow second text so that you have a normal with none and another one with hollow. You're going to download this as a transparent background. So I'm going to select page 2 and I'm going to download it as a transparent background. And I'm going to use my Canva Pro. You're always welcome to go to my Canva Pro link to test the idea out. Once you've downloaded, you're going to add a third page. And then you're going to go to your design. Then add the image that you've just downloaded as a transparent background. You make sure the size of the logo that you want. So depending on how big you want your design to be, first make the sizing and then duplicate the shape or duplicate the image and put it on the side. And then grab the first image, reduce it to a point that you would like to have on your design. So say I want to cut my design where the A ends, and I'm going to size it just where the A ends. I'm going to do that and then crop the little extra space on the side, and it looks like that. Next, I'm going to grab the second image, and then I'm going to crop the portion all the way until where the A ends on the other side. So how you aligning this is very important, otherwise your design is going to look whack, as the kids say. And then crop out the extra space, and then move your design to the center. Then you press R for rectangle to add an extra space, and you zoom in and add a same color rectangle shape in between your letters. We zoom in and we align everything. Nicely done. The only thing we would want to fix over here is this extra little gap that is out, making our design look out of shape. So we're going to press R for rectangle, and you could always use any shape that you want. But just take care, if you are going to convert this to a 3D, make sure that the shape that you're using is white, so that when you are downloading it and you're converting it to 3D on Canva, you know that it has taken away. Because we are using a blue background, I'm going to change the shape to navy blue. Like that. Let's zoom out and check and see if all of our shapes are aligned, and they are. The last thing I would do, I would add the name of the business on that border. So you press T for text. If you want, you could have a nice border around this design of yours. Very nice and thin. And you could zoom in and you could duplicate the shape, rotate that. And there's your design. Group everything.
Head over to your home page and select apps, and head over to Smart Mockups. On your Smart Mockups, pick any mockup that you would like to use. I want to use apparel on this one. So I'm going to pick a t-shirt, and then I'm going to add the mockup directly from a design, or you could use a downloaded design. And then you just add it and you have an amazing looking mockup as well as a design logo. Let me know in the comments below if you've enjoyed this tutorial, if you enjoy these tutorials. Thank you so much for joining me. Head over to our playlist and learn some more and have fun with our magic studio. I will see you on the next video.